Welcome to our world tour using OrbX air scenery, or just OrbX scenery and A2A's aircraft. First short hop, we're going to try and use four aircraft on this flight. In fact, all the A2A aircraft I own. The Cherokee, Comanche, T6 and P51. But we're going to start off in a little short hop for our little Cherokee from NSFA, which is Faleolo, to NSFI, which is Fagali. Never had a good flight on this trip before, so there'd been a night in the T6, funny landing, kind of really scary, and terrible weather in the Cherokee. Last time it was in the Cherokee, I never made it. I had to divert, so let's see if we can get there this time. Okay, fuel pump. Already check, we've got the fuel half and half, okay, prime it. Get three. Locked it. Okay. Throttle a quarter inch. Okay, control. That's okay, normally we would warm us up for 5 minutes, but we're not gonna do that. We're going to warm up while we're moving. Stay. Excuse my erratic taxiing. I've come straight from the Mustang, which is a different setup. Not warming this up very well, am I? Well, it'll be part of the realism. We'll see how accident deals with me doing a very bad, a slow, quick takeoff. Light on. Get a word in edgeways here. Thank you. past the took off. There's a plane's gone rogue. Climb to about 2,000. We'll see. It's a good view. It's one of these tight little airports. It's even when you know where it is, it's pretty hard to actually see it. It's in the dark. A good point of reference is that there is a big ocean liner in the harbour, not far past the airport. It's just over this hill here. There's the ship. So the airport's around here. Let's take a little peek around us. Well, the most exciting of islands, if you want scenery, this one at the moment. When we get our next plane up with a little more speed, the Comanche will be seeing the mountains around here. Weather allowing, of course. Runway is there, we see it. I actually see it this time. It does not. There. There it is. I was going to say, after the other fast planes we've been flying recently, this would not be a relaxing, simple flight. I've got some wind to deal with. Good heavens. That was some interesting wind down back right on the final. Whoa. The plane just dived down. That was a wind shear. Whew. Could have done a go around, but it would. But. Okay.
Now you're going to go to the airport and switch planes to the Comanche.
I know. There's only one. In fact, there isn't a taxiway. It's just...
Piper 730, contact ground on 118.1.
Okay, okay.
118.1,
Piper 730. Quick shutdown. Okay, that's the end of the first leg. We'll switch to the Comanche for the next leg. Outside view. Let's see where we are. I want to see the plane a bit more than that. Can go left a bit more. There you go. That's a bit better. And welcome back. We're now in the Comanche. Let's get moving. Check, we haven't got anything. Okay, computer heat's on, that's it. Now we switched to aircraft. I'm wondering if it... I think the persistent state carries across to an aircraft, it might do.
As we're almost there, it's going to already give us clearance, so we will ask for that, okay? So we can just get moving. Check my flaps, so... Okay, good. And off we go. The creaky sounds. This isn't technically a short field, so I'm not going to use flaps here. or should I? Got an ominous looking mountain head, so yeah, well, I will actually use flaps. But to bear in mind, I'll get a certain amount of lift. First degree on those. carby on. Just because. Don't need the icing to suddenly pop on us. Get a short loop around these mountains and then head off to our destination. Whenever we get altitude around this American Samoa, we get into bad weather. I'd like to do, just pop around that mountain and go out here and compared to the Mustang, the speed obviously much more leisurely. It's good for sightseeing. So good in here somewhere fast. Just trying to get some kind of stable flight situation so I can look around. Should be a ship back here. We don't can't see the ship. Due to time constraints, we're not going to tour all around. We're around here. It's a beautiful area. It's a world tour, not a discover every single. Let's see if we do it. More practical reason we're not going out here is the weather looks inaccessible. I think we would be stupid to go out there. So
That shadow, I think it's a cloud shadow, which is fairly realistic. Good view. That's where we took off from over here. Whoa. Okay, let's get back in the cockpit. Gonna get some interesting effects like this happen. Let's look at the view from the ground. I'm thinking, what's going on with this plane? Poor guy. That's what's going on with the plane. Yeah. American Samoa, bring an umbrella. And I'm over a mountain, of course, so I'm getting the wind shear and stuff. Oh, my passenger just puked. A little bit early, kids. But we see the cloud, we don't want to head into that. Yeah, I think this way would be... That's what we came off on because the weather wasn't too bad over there. Because a huge overspeed now. Hopefully not too much airframe damage. Welcome to the Sloppy's Music Brown Pants Tour. This thing's going like faster than was faster than the Mustang, so this weather. The wind is carrying us at like 60 knots faster than we'd normally be travelling. No, it's not good. Sorry, it's a sim so I can laugh. Would not be doing that in laughing so much in real life. Good grief. Okay, well, I did a bit of a descent there, but not that much. I mean, if I could climb, reduce the speed. Oh! Climb out of the rain, but it's not exactly a path on a plane to climb above the clouds as quick. So down to safe speed again. We are flying to an airport over this ground mass over here. That's where we originally took off in the Cherokee NSFA. Do you reckon a low altitude to get rid of this? Get out of this. It's a tough call. Obviously where we are is going to do it. We got like 80 knots tailwind or something. How the heck can that even happen? We're basically gliding. I could probably turn the engine off and it would fly with this the thermals. I don't have a throttle. I don't have any throttle now. I'm on idle. Colossal speed. It wasn't too bad near the ground, so let's go near the ground while we have a choice in the matter.
kind of dread bleed some speed off. Never a dull man. I just see this big cloud where we're heading as well, so, but it's, I think going low is the option here. Oh, it's not a lightning ahead. I think it's calming down. Yeah, the airport's over here. You can almost see the shimmering already.
It's
20 miles. It's 3 miles a minute. That's 7 minutes. So I can see the airport, which is over here. Trying to carby off now. There's a runway, we can see it. Another airport I've had airy landings at. Well, because of, surprisingly enough, the bad weather. And now we have a, this is the first time I have to make an oration and we've got a tailwind, haven't we? So this is not a good idea. 43. Well, that's, well, it's pretty much a crosswind, isn't it? No, it's not really, is it? It's a semi. It's a tailwind, isn't it? I need to do a circuit. Dang it. Okay. Side. Base leg.
November, Sierra, Mike, Alpha, traffic.
Gonna break the gear. Why not? This would be a high approach, but I'm always doing these where the wind's terrible. Despite the passengers falling deathly silent, that was smooth in. It was a 2,000 feet. This is a long enough runway for this to land halfway down. My legs are a little bit shaky. Let's go to the airport lounge. Order a stiff drink. Shuffling on the turning here to get the thing turned around. So we have to change into it and actually turn into a T6 in a second. Well, I'll do. T6 can manage that. Where's the... That's what I was looking for. Check external views. Oh, now it's clear one way. Oh, too late. Butterflies! Well, it's good enough to finish that recording with. So... our next leg will be in the T6. Goodbye, Comanche. We're now in the T6 Texan by HOA. Flying from... it's a little short hop from NSMA to NSAU. Who? NSAU. Which is Maota to Asau. It is... 26-mile trip, actually. So it really shouldn't take very long. A little bit... I'm sure it'll be a heavy landing because of the weather, but... that's just the way it goes on these flights. So let's see how my memory is for starting this thing off. The flows will be as I decide them. I'm sorry. Parking brake's not on. It is now. Yep, okay. Gallon flap. Didn't prime it. That's good. For the video, so we see the obvious mistake.
This is a tutorial series as well. All these mistakes are deliberate, of course. No, the obvious mistake is we haven't got the magnetos on. I remember that now, because they're in the dark. Here we go. Okay, now we get to start playing. You have learned from Stoppy's music here. Especially with the parking brake that was on, and now he's not. And now he's on. Okay. I did put it on. We saw me put it on, but easy mistake to make. This should be on. Okay. Switching between planes. Well, looks like we're going for a quick takeoff here. It was quicker than I imagined. So I gotta set my trims. Let's get this thing lined up and put the parking brake on. The birds. We don't need a bird strike. We don't have a Hudson to land in. Give me another. Okay, you can see the parking brake this time. Okay, trims, and off we go. Oh, we don't have any rudder. That's not a good thing. We have no rudder. Do now. That was very interesting. Oh, it's a radio beep again. I have rudder, I do have rudder, okay. One of the worst takeoffs ever, I didn't have no rudder steering for a second. Okay. And there you are. Beeping on me. That doesn't look good, is it, flying up through that?
It's too slow.
Well, because of the wind, we're going to go on this way around the island. Is that runway on the left? It's probably me messing up the tailbone steering on takeoff, but never had it so extreme before. Wind is not looking great. So we're going to avoid the high ground.
Oh, here we go again.
Passenger's going.
Way to get off.
All right, let's go to the coast. We have to go around the island, we'll go around the island. It takes a bit longer, but it's safe. Sorry, folks, if you're waiting with anticipation to see the mountains over here, you're not going to. Okay. Isn't it, the clouds are like, they follow us the whole way, don't they? They're taking the boat. You're capsizing the boat. Okay, we've got a red light on for low quantity in the left tank, so we're going to switch tanks. As soon as I can get this thing stable for 1 second. Whoa! Come on, I can't, oh my god. Okay, we switch tanks to the right tank. My passenger demanded we have a smaller tank so he could carry his luggage. Oh, this is not the world tour I had imagined. The right tank goes low quantity. We're obviously using way much more fuel than we would because this weather didn't help. Trim, obviously, oh yeah, another 240 miles per hour. I'm like, and climbing. That's not right. Okay, we seem to have stabilized. Looks. And, okay. We're gonna check the tank situation. Fuel. We're good. Not if we get any more bad weather, we're good. Make some speed records with the plane. I'm trying to make the flight fairly short by flying over here. Just obviously the clouds are kind of scary. Like, I don't really want to fly into that. Any sign of turbulence, we're going to be skipping back. More to the left. It's smooth enough now. Canopy's still open. Should we close it now? Yeah. Doesn't improve the weather, it just takes away the. I think we can take our shortcut now because I see clear skies there. We've still got rain. But, yeah, but you can't see the wind. I've got weather radar, but I'm not using it because it's not very realistic for this plane. If you climb over here, the runway is ahead of us. It's over the top of this hill. We already know the wind is heading, it's coming from the east. I'm already starting to turn the right direction because I know where the airport is. We need to conserve fuel by not doing too much sightseeing. There's the runway.
so I can really turn it much earlier and slow things down. Save fuel as well. So, I do have like 5,000, 6,000 feet to go down, so. That would reduce the burn. We'll switch tanks now, actually, to the left tank. Nope. That was off. Mouse wheel, that is. That's the mouse wheel. I have to check the cylinder head temperature with a low manifold pressure that will drop very quickly. So I have to flip the throttle down again. Yeah, turn the radios on. I still haven't figured that bleep out. I'll get rid of that. I'll go away. Pretty high, but we can do with this. It's usual last minute full flaps landing, but we're not flying so fast as we're in the Mustang. Can't see nothing. It's just not good. I want to do that this time. To stop us. Whoa. It is. Go. Cool. bit dodgy heading here. It's late in the tour for tonight. I've just got one flight left to do. Semi-realistic, tired pilot. It's the Mustang with a quick flight back. Come bang! So I'm doing that tonight. Here we get the landing light warning on there, you see. But the gear should be down, see, we've got landing light warning on. I mean, landing gear warning on. Which is interesting. That's only a very minor bug, I don't really care about that. So we're going to. Well, that'll turn the warning off, turn the battery off. Outside view. Obviously, they haven't spent a lot of time in this airport. It's pretty basic. Not even anybody waiting for us. That's kind of rude, isn't it? Your friends didn't bother turning up. And welcome back to the final leg of our American Samoa tour from Asau Airport, NSAU, to Faleolo International, NSFA. This will be a get back to base as soon as possible kind of flight. We have a mountain in the way and we've had bad weather, but we're fortunate to have speed, so we can avoid all that and still get there in a good amount of time. Shouldn't be more than, it's 41 miles, so we're probably talking like 20 minutes, 15 minutes. See how I can get on with starting this one from memory. Switching between planes is a task, especially when the view switches around to the rear. Okay. My flows is not going to be good. Sorry, it's all about getting thing in the air. Make sure the parking brake's on, brake's down. It's on because last time we started the T6 on. I swear I put it on. Let's open the canopy. Throttle quarter inch mixture. I think this mixture's full rich on this one. Well, that's for you. Memory block for you. Runway 8 because another wind is coming from that direction, so we can get moving.
November Sierra Alpha Uniform with traffic. 114237, taxiing to runway 8.
I believe I have flaps down. Do, see. Fix that one. Short field takeoff, and I'm still. Inexperienced at these. And it's a Mustang, of course. Tons of power. Trim, of course. Sorry. Stick the. Because I'm switching between aircraft. Trim's always in a different place. Set it here. I get off the ground early and I control it with white air on if I have to. I think it's straight ahead of us, isn't it? Good old weather.
I will be so glad to get off the ground this. It's been a long and fun tour with four different planes, and stressful switching between them. And once I can land, take off in this one, on this silly short runway,
I will be happy, because then it's going to be plane flying. Excuse me. Okay. But the runway looks incredibly short from that view, doesn't it, really? It does. It looks very short.
Less than conventional, but I got it in the air. All right, geared up. We'll confirm that.
Okay. As soon as I get it stable, I'm gonna get rid of this rudder trim. Now, okay.
Now we can fly. Now we don't really want to go to the mountains up there on the right, because well, you never know the wind. But we had some bad weather here, so we're going to fly low and fast. So not going to blow the engine up doing it. Big black cloud up there. We're just going to go nowhere near that. Like a tree. Head's a tree. Okay. What pudding does that remind you of? Caramel custard, isn't it? Caramel cream.
Yeah.
Caramel cream mountain. I have to admit, this is my favourite of all the 808 planes I have so far. I will own the P40. For too long, but I'm loving this. The speed we're getting from A to B, and the sheer fun of flying it. Because we hit a dam daft here where we're pretty well in trouble. But so I've gone a little bit near the top of the mountain we couldn't see before, which is over here. It's not much of a top of a mountain. I don't think we've missed that much. And our airport we're landing at is over here. We'll fly over the airport that we'd have the earlier one. The NSMA. Mau. And because we can and we're in a fighter plane, we'll be picking up speed doing that. so it's so many hours, like thousands, I guess, really, flying nothing but IFR on my early days in flight simulator with my TC was so rubbish that I only flew at night. I'm really starting to enjoy VFR again. But just flying by, especially now I have the scenery, flying by what you can see rather than relying on the seat controls. I haven't even bothered to tune the VOR into where we're going, because I need we have good visibility. Now we're 300 knots and here's the airfield we land at Erdo. When we hit some bad weather, we go to a little flyby. There it is. The weather's not great, but it's... I mean, I don't think it's just because we're going quicker. I mean, you think, I don't know. It would be nice to have... Well, if I had good weather here, it would be boring, because we'd be flying straight and level. Just controlled. You just have to fast forward into the deep boring. There's a runway there. Where do you see it? I guess we need to add the mission. It's kind of. It's hard to trim the plane when the wind is doing this. Rather climbing at the same rate or diving. Most of them have got to slow down. Yeah. I'm hoping once we get below 1,000, I don't have this ridiculous amount of wind shear, whatever it is. When you want a long runway, I've got one. So, yeah, we've got a 9,000 foot runway. Yeah. Guess we're gonna get down. Still gonna be fun. Yeah, this is gonna be fun. When they're bad weather conditions, you shouldn't really have a lot of flap. So I'm not using a lot of flap at the moment. It calms down. I will use some more. Okay, it's calmed down. happy saying we're well too low, but I don't really trust that. Because we seem to be like too high, but we're slowing down. I'm trying not to avoid the double, the bouncing when we get here. And I avoided the bounce. So I can keep on the straight on the runway. And I did. No bounce. About a mile, literally probably a mile down the runway when we landed. I want to park out of front. Yeah, but it's going to make me park over here, so I will follow orders. I will follow orders, and then I may well, once it's, it'll say taxi to take off, taxi to take off options down there. If I get it correct, and then I'll move to where I want to go. But by the oil tankers, I mean the gas tanker, so it'll probably refuel us automatically, whether we like it or not here. It's never really trustworthy. See, it's not actually putting us where we want. So I'm going to ignore the instructions. Even though I went to where I'm supposed to, we're going to park it right outside the front. So we're VIPs. Our passengers have been awarded the brown trouser medal for not requiring brown trousers. People want to, I think that's pretty well the entrance. There we go. So that's parking brake on. Canopy open. Well, actually shut in this case because I had it open the whole time. Learn from my mistakes, people. Work. An outside view. And that might be a good finishing shot. I can't see the airport. There we go. Thank you for watching Stubby's Music World Tour of American Samoa, Western Islands.